Blackstone Audio presents The Lost Daughter by Elena Ferrante, translated by Anne Goldstein. This book is read by Hilary Huber. 1. I had been driving for less than an hour when I began to feel ill. The burning in my side came back, but at first I decided not to give it any importance. I became worried only when I realized that I no longer had the strength to hold on to the steering wheel. In the space of a few minutes, my head became heavy. The headlights grew dimmer. Soon, I even forgot that I was driving. I had the impression, rather, of being at the sea in the middle of the day. The beach was empty, the water calm, but on a pole a few meters from shore, a red flag was waving. When I was a child, my mother had frightened me, saying, "Leda, you must never go swimming if you see a red flag. It means the sea is rough and you might drown." That fear had endured through the years, and even now, although the water was a sheet of translucent paper stretching to the horizon, I didn't dare go in. I was anxious. I said to myself, "Go on, swim." They must have forgotten the flag. And meanwhile, I stayed on the shore, cautiously testing the water with the tip of my toe. Only at intervals, my mother appeared at the top of the dunes and shouted to me as if I were still a child, "Leda, what are you doing? Don't you see the red flag?" In the hospital, when I opened my eyes, I saw myself again hesitating for a fraction of a second before the flat sea. Maybe that was why, later, I convinced myself that it wasn't a dream, but a fantasy of alarm that lasted until I woke up in the hospital room. The doctors told me that my car had ended up against the guardrail, but without critical consequences. The only serious injury was in my left side, an inexplicable lesion. My friends from Florence came, Bianca and Marta returned, and even Gianni. I said it was drowsiness that had sent me off the road, but I knew very well that drowsiness wasn't to blame. At the origin was a gesture of mine that made no sense, and which, precisely because it was senseless, I immediately decided not to speak of to anyone. The hardest things to talk about are the ones we ourselves can't understand. 2. When my daughters moved to Toronto, where their father had lived and worked for years, I was embarrassed and amazed to discover that I wasn't upset. Rather, I felt light, as if only then had I definitively brought them into the world. For the first time in almost 25 years, I was not aware of the anxiety of having to take care of them. The house was neat, as if no one lived there. I no longer had the constant bother of shopping and doing the laundry. The woman who for years had helped with the household chores found a better-paying job, and I felt no need to replace her. My only obligation with regard to the girls was to call once a day to see how they were, what they were doing. On the phone, they spoke as if they were on their own. In reality, they lived with their father. But, accustomed to keeping us separate even in words, they spoke to me as if he didn't exist. To my questions on the state of their lives, they answered either in a cheerfully evasive manner, or with an ill humor full of irritable pauses, or in the artificial tones they assumed when they were in the company of friends. They called me often, too, especially Bianca, who had a more imperiously demanding relationship with me, but only to know if blue shoes would go with an orange skirt, if I could find some papers left in a book and send them urgently, if I was still available to be blamed for their rages, their sorrows, in spite of the different continents and the spacious sky that separated us. The telephone calls were almost always hurried. Sometimes they seemed fake, as in a movie. I did what they asked, reacted in accordance with their expectations. But since distance imposed the physical impossibility of intervening directly in their lives, satisfying their desires or whims became a mixture of rarefied.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.